What's going on, guys, and welcome on in. Today let's talk about the top 5 beginner mistakes I see being made in Epic 7. Now the game has gotten a lot easier with the adventure path, a lot of quality of life. Smogate's done a lot of great things to help new players with free gear, etc. But there's still a lot of traps I see that players fall into in which they could have reached mid to end game a lot more efficiently. So let's go over my top 5 mistakes I see, kind of what I think about, how you can do them better. And if you guys have any extra comments or mistakes maybe you personally made and would like to share, please let me know in the comments below. My last video with the tips and tricks one, I got a lot of great advice, so I'd love to hear from you guys, all right? All right, guys, let's talk about mistake number one, the biggest mistake I see new players making, and a lot of y'all can probably guess it already. That would be Molagora, or wasting or using Molagoras inefficiently. A lot of new players I'll see will be spreading them out really thinly on new units they find fun, units they're just testing out, or units, you know, that maybe wouldn't really get them a lot of early game progress. Instead, I think a lot of units you can get away with using little to no Molagoras, and then for the very important units that kind of carry you, those are going to be the ones you want to invest in the most early. So your DPS units typically, or your farmer units. The Knights and Soul Weavers in this example I'm showing here, let's take Rowana for example. If you pull a Rowana early, that's very, very easy raids, hell raids, some hunts. She can get away with as little as zero Molagora. I think I have 2 skill enhancements in her right now, which could be zero and she would still work just fine. Eventually for PvP, of course, you want to max out the S2 a little more, maybe get the minus cooldown in S3, but for an early game player and even in PvP later, or early, excuse me, she can get away with zero. Same thing with Crow. I think Crow I have more in, but that's more of a luxury thing. I used him for a long time at zero. You do want the minus cooldown on 3, and then the S2, I believe, extra in S2 can kind of help with the defense up damage. But Crow also needs zero. Now, if we look at Vildred though, Vildred was one of my very first units. He was my farmer, my PvP cleaver, and I used him in, I think, what, Banshee and A13 very early. So if you have a unit like that where without the molas, you know, their damage is not enough to get through phases or kill the boss period, then that's kind of where you want to pump the most molas in. And if you test out a lot of varied units or invest molas into units that don't need them early, like Rowana and Crow, your tanks and soul weavers, then your DPS units are kind of left out to dry. Okay, so look at units that are well-rounded, meaning you can use them in a lot of areas, farming, hunts, raids, and then also look into what you need to finish early. PvP can wait for a little while. You kind of just use your hunts and raid teams for PvP in the beginning just to get some early conquest points and free sky stones per week. But focus on, let's say, Wyvern 13 into normal raid, into hell raid. So what units are good at that? Look at the ice units and then invest first in the DPS portion of those carries and those comps, right? So if, let's say, we have a Crow, Momo, Cigarette, and Terranor guard team, we want to invest mostly into Cigarette first and then the few molas extra into maybe Crow, and Momo of course won't need it, but let's say you're using Angelica into that, for example, right? More into the DPS and less into that. And of course, guys, you're gonna pull some new units, maybe 4 stars, 5 stars, ML units that you really want to invest in. And always play how you want, enjoy the game at your own pace, but just keep in mind, if you spread your molas thin early, you will lose progress, and that may hamper your, you know, efficiency later on. Meaning, if you just kind of focus on a set path in the beginning, you can get more molas later on through things like Abyss, auto fully clearing auto tower, for example, things like that. In which case, if you kind of just invested mola poorly in a lot of fun units that you pulled randomly, well, then it's gonna take longer to reach the end game. Okay, so play for fun always. Make sure you're enjoying the game, but try to be efficient, especially with Molagora, because it's an extremely, extremely rare resource, okay? If you have any additional questions on this, please leave them in the comments below or hit up my Twitch channel or Discord, all right? I know it's a very advanced topic. All right, guys, after Molagora, let's talk about the next 2 mistakes together, and that is gold and energy. Poor or wasting of gold and energy. You know, a lot of new players, you're not gonna have enough gold and energy to play a lot. Well, that's probably because you're using it a little bit inefficiently, and let me give you some tips to maybe stretch those limited resources a lot farther so you can get a lot more done in your day. Now remember, guys, of course, even though I think energy and gold Smilegate has done a much better job nowadays of giving us more, especially as free to play. You'll never be able to play 24/7 as if you're not spending cash. That's just kind of the game we play. But I'll give you some tips so that you can get a lot more done with what you're given. All right. So the number one tip I think will be to farm smarter. I don't mean just farming during hunt or buff events, which we'll talk about in just a second, but I just mean, let's take for example, you're trying to get some farm some catalysts. Make sure you're doing as many objectives together as possible. Always be double dipping. What do I mean by that? Well, let's say you're trying to farm some epic catalysts. Pick a stage that drops some rare catalysts that you might need too. Make sure it's in unrecorded history because you get more AP there than the normal stages. A lot of players don't know that. And then make sure as well, you're also bringing either fodder to level, units to level, or maybe units that you need friendship on. Just try to be getting as much as possible with whatever energy, resource, mission, or adventure, whatever you're trying to get done with energy, make sure you're doing as many things together as possible because you don't have a lot of energy realistically as free to play or new players, and you want to stretch it as thinly as possible. Make sure you get as much done as possible. On top of that, I talked about hunt events and buffs. Those typically happen once a month, but there's no set schedule. But always keep an eye out for when the most important thing, I think, for gold is the hunt event, of course. That's how I get all this gold. I farm primarily during hunt. That's where I save up all my Leafs, and I'll spend some Skystones as well. But I farm regularly with the free energy, and then I go really ham during the hunt events, and that's how I save up most of my gold. Beyond that, let's say you see a guide that wants you to build up like Angelic Montmorency, Adventure Roz, Falconer Clurry, and you know you're gonna need a ton of runes for this skill tree. Maybe try and save as long as possible for the double Spirit Altar event. I know you can't always be bothered to wait the entire month if you missed it, so sometimes you'll need that Montmo immediately to finish Wyvern 13. Just get it done immediately. But let's say you're farming Spirit Runes there, make sure maybe you can level fodder in a stage 9 or stage 8. That might be better than just going stage 10 and trying to get a little more done there, right? Depends what you need, but always be double dipping. Always try to make use of hunt events and things like that. And then the last tip, guys, a lot of new players aren't taking advantage of the free Leafs and gold you can get. Where do I get these free stuff? Well, the number one thing is probably per week is, let's start with the easier one, and that's the Discord question of the week. There's the E7 official Discord. You fill out a 20-second survey. You just put in your name, your Discord name, and they'll ask you a few questions, which are honestly really good feedback so that they can constantly improve. And then they hand you, I think, 2 free Leafs per week just for doing that. Just get in the habit, form it, and they really, really add up so that you can save up those Leafs for that very valuable hunt event like I was talking about. On top of that, per week, there is 1 to 2... streams usually that happen. There's always the normal stream, but sometimes they'll do the content stream as well, the Korean one, in which case these will give you somewhere 4 to 5 Leafs plus like I think 300k gold per week. So make sure you take advantage of them as well, guys. They're very valuable. They add up, of course, if you have Amazon Prime, things like that. Make sure you get it, do your daily logins, but those are the main ones you can always get, and they're very little effort. Just form a habit, get them done. If you don't know how to do any of those, I'll leave the links in the description below, okay? Alright y'all, mistake number 4, and this is a big one that I think a lot of players miss out on, is not taking advantage of being in a good guild. Emphasis on good, because, you know, being in a guild, period, is better than being in no guild, but I'm going to list out a list of benefits that you should be getting from your current guild, and if you're not getting all of these, well, it might be time to start looking at, you know, searching for a new home to call. So, what kind of benefits do you need from your guild? Number 1, I think, of course, will be, is your guild keeping the bonus battle XP and gold? They should be keeping this up 24/7. In an active guild, this is extremely simple to do, so this is number 1. If your guild isn't doing this, really, really consider looking into getting into a new guild, or if you're with friends, trying to push them to recruit more people, be more active, so that way you can keep those buffs active 24/7. After that, guys, is your guild requesting catalysts or weird things where you're not getting as many brave crests as you should be? Time to start looking into other guilds or letting them know that the best way is either trading the spirit runes. We like to trade the mana drake claws from hunts because they're very easy to get. Usually you don't even need to farm these, but try to avoid in the beginning, at least, you know, it's a little bit greedy to ask for catalysts, because instead you could all be farming those on your own time. and be getting Brave Crest by just trading very, very easy stuff like this. It's free currency, which you can exchange for, of course, if you guys have seen Molagoras, best way to get artifact charms, equipment conversion gems, things like that. All right. That's tip number two. And then number three is your guild being active in guild wars. Okay. Being a good guild doesn't mean you have to be five times rewards or a top 100 guild. Just being active, in my opinion, is the trademark of a good guild. Even if you're, you know, not doing too well in the beginning, it's something you can work on together. And even losing gets you some mystics, but participating, and you know, you will get wins eventually. Just getting mystics, period, is such a huge advantage. So make sure you have enough players to get into guild wars. So either you have to recruit, look for a new guild, or, you know, try to get your friends to move with you. Just make sure you're doing guild wars, period. A lot of players miss out on that. Now, after that, guys, I know it may be hard to find a quote-unquote good guild, but I have five or six different guilds personally that I have people running, and they're all active. They range from casual to, you know, let's say try hard, higher levels of play. So if you are looking for guild, guys, I probably have one just for you. We still have a few slots, I think, in every single guild. We even have a EU guild, but no Asia one yet, mostly global. Go ahead and hit up the Discord in the description below and we can start talking. Let me get you guys in there, get in an active guild. There's so many resources to be had in there. All right, don't miss out on that. Okay, guys, last but not least, mistake number five, and that is neglecting arena. When I do a lot of reviews for new players, I see them stacking a ton of arena flags. They're not utilizing them at all sometimes for various reasons. Either you don't like arena, or maybe you just don't think you're ready yet. Well, guys, using your arena flags on cooldown, especially as free to play, as well as getting these very valuable conquest points, because as we know, you get gear, charms, slates. They're extremely valuable, even more so for a new player, which is why it's kind of hard when I understand the reasons not to do arena, but even more so as a new player, you need to be forcing yourself to be trying to do as many of these as possible. I'm not talking NPC challenges. Of course, if you're not doing these, you have to be doing these. Good source of conquest points, sky stones. Everybody has no issue doing this. It's versus AI. It's easy. It's quick. But when we start getting into, you know, actually fighting player-made defenses, some people either think they're not ready, in which case I say, even at bronze, silver, and gold, you'd be surprised what your Wyvern or PvE team can beat. Just give it a shot. Even if you lose, you still get conquest points, which is going to lead into one of my bigger tips or tricks I'm about to tell you about in just a second. But just try. Use your best geared units. It's okay that they're not built for PvP. It's okay they're not highest on the tier list. Just use what you have gear on, and you'd be surprised at lower levels what you can get away with beating. Maybe you'll teach yourself a thing or two. Just give it a shot. You get those conquest points. You'll get higher up in the rankings, in which case you'll get more sky stones per week. And just use those Wyvern teams, use those raid teams, all right? Trust me, in the beginning, just use those flags on the daily, get the free flags. Make sure this is always at zero. Don't do what Car's doing here. I have 5 out of 5. Make sure it's always 0 out of 5 as long as possible, okay? Now, for my guys watching that really hate arena, I know you're out there. It's okay, but you still want to be doing this because this is going to fund your PvE adventures as well, okay? Your collection, if you're a collector, this will kind of give you more resources for that too. So I'm going to try and do this together with y'all on stream. Or sorry, not on stream, on recording for YouTube. But let me show you what I'm about to do. You might be confused at first, but watch, okay? So I'm just going to jump in. We're going to fight Mr. Ghost Hands here. And you might be surprised about what I'm about to do. But I'm going to immediately yield out, okay? I shouldn't be doing this close to the end of the week because I fell out of champion, but let me show you guys. We'll learn together, all right? I'm going to yield out. I'm going to hit retry. As you saw, I got conquest points for losing. But watch, we're going to do it one more time. Well, we'll do it more than two times, but the second try, we're going to lose points again. First time we lost 8 points. Same thing, right? I just picked any opponent. I'm going to hit yield. As you see here, we're going to lose another 8 points, but we still get the conquest points, right? And here's the nice part, guys. Let's do it the third time. Check this out. By the way, if you want to do this quick, try to find a team you outspeed. That way, you don't have to wait for the AI. Sometimes you can't yield before the AI will take a turn. So try to pick a slower team. Just helps with the time efficiency. But yield again. Check this out. Third try. Oh, also, get your daily arenas done. Guys, third try, We lose no points, okay? I think you still get a bonus for streaks. It's extra conquest points that will add up. You get your daily arenas done, and it's super quick and simple, okay? You will lose some points here and there, but after the third time, you can do this from Monday to Sunday. Just keep throwing in your teams, yielding out, and you will get your conquest points if you absolutely hate arena. I would advise, though, if you don't mind arena at all, like I said before, just throw in your PvE teams. Try to get as high as possible. You can get more sky stones, and this is the alternative if you absolutely hate arena, okay? Just make sure you get those conquest points, guys. Make sure you get these for all the free gear, slates, and things like that, okay? Charms. All right, y'all. And with that, I think we're done with the top five mistakes that I consider players can make better use of, okay? If you guys have any extra tips or mistakes you've made, like I said in the beginning, please let me know in the comments below. Make sure if you need a guild, guys, hit up my Discord. Come hang out with me on stream. We can talk about advice, things like that. And as always, thank you so much for watching. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out, y'all.